I welcome all of you to Rashtrapati Bhavan. I congratulate you on your success in an extremely tough and competitive examination and your entry into the Indian Police Service. I am sure that all of you realize that being an IPS officer places an enormous responsibility on your shoulders. It is a service that is one of the pillars of our national administrative system. It is also a service that defines the trust of common citizens in our police forces. Citizens see you as officers who will uphold the rule of law and enable delivery of justice. This is a big responsibility, and I am sure you will prove worthy of it. As members of an All India service, you will no doubt serve in individual states, but you will represent a national idea. Your mandate is to uphold a common concept of the rule of law and of our democratic polity. In that sense, you are guardians of not just public order and honest conduct, but of the majesty of law. Governments come and go, but you represent continuity and you represent the Constitution. Being an IPS officer gives you privileges and powers that are actually tools to serve the people. Your primary duty is to serve common citizens and ensure justice to the poorest of the poor. It is very rare that a profession allows one to make a difference to the lives of not just a few people, but thousands. You are joining one such rare profession, and you must take this opportunity as a blessing. कुछ लोगों का ये मानना है कि किसी समाज का और उसके राष्ट्रीय विकास का मूल्यांकन वहाँ के पुलिस व्यवस्था की गुणवत्ता से किया जा सकता है. पुलिस कई मायनों में स्वयं प्रशासन की गुणवत्ता का प्रतिबिंब और प्रतीक होती है. किसी सामान्य नागरिक के लिए या देश में आने वाले किसी अन्य व्यक्ति के लिए प्रशासन व्यवस्था की पहचान सिग्नल पर खड़े यातायात कर्मी, गली मोहल्ले में गश्त करने वाले बीट अधिकारी और किसी पुलिस स्टेशन में स्वागत डेस्क पर बैठे अधिकारी के साथ उसकी बातचीत और उससे बनी छवि से होती है. हमारे लिए ये जरूरी है कि मूलभूत पुलिस व्यवस्था को बेहतर बनाने के लिए हम सभी आवश्यक कदम उठाएं. किसी भी संवेदनशील एवं पेशेवर पुलिस बल की विशेषता भी यही होती है. ऐसा करने से हमें इस प्रकार का वातावरण बनाने में मदद मिलेगी जिसमें कानून लागू करने वाले अधिकारी से डरने के स्थान पर नागरिक कानून से डरें और उसका सम्मान करें. हमारे पुलिस बलों में अधिकारी के पद पर होने के नाते इस मामले में आप सच्चा योगदान कर सकते हैं. आपको चाहिए कि आप ऐसा उदाहरण पेश करते हुए अपने कर्तव्यों का पालन किसी भय या पक्षपात और विलंब के बिना करें. पेशेवर सिविल अधिकारियों के रूप में अपने राजनीतिक उच्च अधिकारियों को आप अपनी ईमानदार और पक्षपात रहित सलाह देने के लिए सदैव तत्पर रहें. आप भारत के संविधान को ही हमेशा सबसे ऊपर समझें और उसी के अनुसार काम करें. As senior police officers, you will be confronted with several challenges. Some of these are peculiar to the times we live in. For instance, there is challenge posed by terrorism and left-wing extremism, which have both domestic and international dimensions. I have no doubt that you will take on these challenges with full determination, but you must do so in a way that innocent bystanders do not suffer. You will also be confronted with crimes that have emerged with economic growth and technological advance. Our police forces must invest in building specialization to prevent, manage, and mitigate white-collar and corporate crimes. And while technology and the internet are changing our society for the better, they are also creating avenues for sophisticated digital crimes. Again, I am sure that all of you, the young leaders of our police forces, will rise to the occasion and ensure that we can overcome these challenges. Technology is both a challenge and a tool. Technology allows you to do your duties with greater efficiency. It also allows the citizen to interact with the police force and even to lodge a complaint from the comfort of his or her home and computer or mobile phone. Please encourage this process. The ideal police system is one where the citizen gets due service from the police without needing to visit the police station. I would end by saying what I always tell the officer in trainees from different services who visit Rashtrapati Bhavan. While you should seek both professional and personal success, please do not lose sight of the fact that all of you are privileged to some manner or the other, by virtue of education or position or in some other way. As IPS officers, you are expected to be leaders of the police forces and do your duty with utmost integrity. But you must do more than that. You must also give back to the society and to those who are less privileged. How you choose to do this is something I leave it to you. But do remember that each of you, and indeed all of us in this room, are obliged to make a positive contribution to the lives of those who are less privileged than us. I wish all of you a long and satisfying career in the service of our country. Thank you. Jai Hind.